in America are eating way too much sugar. If you don't get anything else from any of these videos that you're watching, but you cut your sugar down to a healthy amount, it could very well save your life. In fact, it's 150 to 170 pounds of sugar the average American is eating. Did you know that food companies know exactly how much sugar to put in something that addicts you to their product? Food companies are amazing at this. They're the best in the world. Their job is to sell food. For the ages of 18 to 54 in the United States right now, the leading cause of death is soda. We are drinking way too much soda in the United States, and it is killing us. We are drinking liquid poison. Fructose, which is high fructose corn syrup, it's also the sugar that is found in fruit, which in its whole food form, if you eat an apple as an apple, it has fructose in it, but the fiber protects your body against the harmful sides that the fructose has. Fructose is a hepatopoison, a liver poison, just like alcohol. In fact, ounce for ounce, it has the same effects on your liver as alcohol does. If you're drinking alcohol, you have what's called a negative feedback loop. You can only drink so much alcohol until you pass out. Soda, you can just keep drinking and drinking and drinking and drinking. By the year 2050, experts are predicting that 95% of the American population will be overweight or obese. We're at 70% right now. And if you think the fix is outside of yourself, that very thought process is the problem. Until you understand that you're the person who's the problem, change will never happen. But as soon as you're able to take ownership, wow, I have a problem, that allows you the ability to start being responsible for yourself, or I like to break that word apart, response-able, or able to respond to your circumstance that you're in. If you're overweight or obese, you need the ability to respond to that. But you will never have that ability if you don't, first of all, acknowledge the fact that you are the problem and you are the cause of your condition. Sugar is the number one additive in the United States. In fact, when you go to the interior of your grocery store, you know, I always said shop the exterior. When you go to the interior, 80% of items that come in a box or a bag in your grocery store have added sugar in them. It is harder to find products that don't have added sugar than it is to find products with added sugar. Just one can of soda a day. That equals between 15 and 20 pounds of weight gain throughout the year. And I also want to be really clear, it doesn't matter if you're drinking juice or if you're drinking soda. The sugar rush to the liver is the same. It's the same damaging effects. It's the same weight gain effects. The only difference between the juice is you actually get some nutritional value from some of the stuff in the juice. So I don't recommend juicing. If you want to do smoothies, that's fine. You don't want to take and separate the fiber from the fruit. That is the key. Don't separate those two things. When you separate those two things, that's where you run into some issues. How much sugar is too much? When you look at a nutrition label, which we have another video on how to read nutrition labels, but when you look at a nutrition label, if you notice by the sugar content, there's no percentage. Food companies just don't want you to know how much sugar you're actually having. You need to be an educated consumer and know how much sugar you should be having. Men, you should have no more than 37.5 grams of added sugar per day. These are standards by the American Heart Association, by the way. Women, you should have no more than 25 grams of added sugar a day, and kids, no more than 16 grams of added sugar a day. So if you have something handy, a nutrition label handy, look at it. Look how many grams of sugar are in it, and you tell me, is there a lot of sugar in this item? You also need to make sure that you're aware of the serving size, because let's say there's 10 grams of serving in there, but the serving size is a tablespoon. Well, I don't know about you, but a tablespoon is not a lot. So you may be, when you're eating, having two or three servings of that. And in one sitting with one food additive, you may be getting all of the sugar for your entire day in and not even be aware of that. I think that we should have billboards that show a child getting candy from an adult and a child getting a cigarette from an adult. Because here's the reality. More kids today are going to die from sugar addiction than will die from cigarette addictions. Cigarette smoking has been demonized in America today, which is great. It should be. It's deadly. But you know what's more deadly is sugar, and it's not demonized. Nobody's saying this. If you give a kid a cigarette right now, will they take one puff, two puffs, and then die? No. If you give a kid a sucker, are they going to have one sucker, two suckers, and then die? Absolutely not. Well, unless they choke on it, then it's a possibility. It would be outrageous for a trick-or-treater to come by and for somebody to be passing out cigarettes. That person would get arrested, and rightfully so. We're handing candy to our kids, and that is going to be what addicts them to sugar and what eventually ends their life. Now, if you're listening right now and you have a weight problem, don't you want to keep your kids from having that same weight problem? Don't you want to keep your kids from having to yo-yo diet all of their life and always be ashamed with the way they looked? Not have the energy to do and live the life that they really wanted like you have? Do you want that for them? Do you want them to have the embarrassment of when they go on an airplane and fly, they have to get that seatbelt extender? So how do you prevent that? First of all, you have to stop feeding them the way you're feeding them right now. Our kids wake up in the morning, we want to feed them something healthy, so we pick out Cheerios because the box says we are heart healthy, so we're going to give our kids some heart healthy Cheerios. Or maybe something more like Raisin Bran, because that stuff, you know, when I was growing up, I didn't like Raisin Bran. If it tastes bad, it must be good for you, right? So, Raisin Bran, I'll get my kids some Raisin Bran. It'll be great for them. Raisin Bran has 18 grams of sugar per serving. Now remember how much sugar should a child have. If you thought in your head or if you said out loud, 16, you're right. So in one serving of Raisin Bran, they have already met their sugar allotment for the day. But we're not done there. We're going to give them a half a cup. We're going to give them a cup of milk. 1% milk has another 13 grams of sugar in it. We're going to give them a cup of orange juice because they need their vitamin C. Get your vitamin C in, kid. Give them a cup of orange juice, which has 21 grams of sugar in it. So total breakfast before the kid even walks out the door to school, they have 52 grams of sugar. Now, if you're good with math, that's about three times what they should have, and they just started their day. Then, you know, we packed them a lunch, which is good. We should pack our kids a lunch. It's great. And we gave them a granola bar for a snack, which has another 16 grams of sugar. We thought it was healthy for them because it's a granola bar, right? Lunch, you know, the kid needs a treat, so we threw some gummy bears in there because they like the gummy bears. We gave them a chocolate milk because they need the calcium, which has another 24 grams of sugar in it. We gave them two slices of bread because we made a sandwich, which is peanut butter and jelly, of course, which the jelly, by the way, has 18 grams of sugar in it per serving. The peanut butter is a little bit better, but it has 3 grams of sugar per serving. So now we're up to 71 grams of sugar for lunch. And our total for the day is 139 grams of sugar. And we haven't ate dinner yet. That's why we have 4-year-olds today getting diagnosed with type 2 diabetes, which normally doesn't happen until you're 30, 40, 50, 60. So do your kids a favor and do the children in your life a favor and don't feed them all the sugar. Be a responsible adult and make sure they're not eating too much sugar. So what are some sugar alternatives that we can use? Now, I talked through a few. There's things called sugar alcohols. Anything that ends in an O-L, mannitol, xylitol, erythritol, those are sugar alcohols. That doesn't mean they're alcohol, but when we're looking at chemistry, they call them alcohols. Those can be good ways to substitute a sugar in a natural way, but you don't want too much of that. You want to make sure that your pets don't get a hold of that. And also super young kids, it can be damaging on their digestive systems. For pets, for dogs specifically, it's poisonous. So you don't want to give them a sugar alcohol at all. It's not my favorite. I don't want you to have a lot of that. It's not like I want you to take and replace your sugar with sugar alcohol. But sugar alcohol is a little bit better than having just sugar. The next thing that you have is you have your artificial sweeteners. You have your aspartame, your sucralose, your acesulfates. All of those are artificial sweeteners. A lot of your popular ones are like the pink packet, Sweet and Low, right? It's a really popular artificial sugar. Diet Pop is artificial sugar. Coke Zero has artificial sugar. Artificial sugar in the most recent studies have been linked to Alzheimer's and dementia and brain problems. Stay away from your artificial sweeteners. They're not good for you. I would rather have you have real sugar than artificial. My two favorite are stevia. It's a plant-based sweetener that still is zero calories. It's great. Plant-based sweetener. We actually have our own liquid form at the office, and we have like 15 different flavors. They are phenomenal. You can walk into a VitaLife location and buy one of those. My personal favorite is English toffee because I'm a big English toffee nut. You can get English toffee liquid stevia. It goes great in your coffee. It goes great on an apple. It makes it taste like a caramel apple. So many different ways that you can use that as a sweetener. I love it. The last sweetener that I'm really excited about and has really only become commercially available within the last couple of years is something called monk fruit. It's a priest fruit. No, I'm just kidding. Monk fruit is a fruit, but its sweetness comes from an antioxidant in the fruit, not from the sugar. So when they process monk fruit, they're actually getting rid of the sugar in the fruit and they're just having an antioxidant. So it's the antioxidant property that gives it the sweetness. An antioxidant is something that helps protect our body from something called free radicals. Free radicals are damaging properties that actually are the cause of us aging. So when we smoke a cigarette, we have massive free radical damage in our body. When we get sunburned, we have massive free radical damage. When we eat rancid foods or even processed foods, there's massive free radical release in our body. So the key to that is we're going to be exposed to that throughout life, but the key is having the proper antioxidants to combat the free radicals. What's amazing about the antioxidant monk fruit is not only do we get the sweetness that we like, but we also are protecting our bodies from the free radical damage. So monk fruit is great, and we actually have some monk fruit in our office as well. Monk fruit is available at some of your local grocery stores. I know Fresh Thyme carries a monk fruit sweetener. What you want to be careful of is you don't want, sometimes they'll mix the monk fruit with some of your sugar alcohols, xylitol, erythritol, mannitol. You want to make sure that if they've mixed it with those, that it's organically sourced sugar alcohols. A lot of your sugar alcohols are laced with pesticides, and I would recommend that you stay away from anything in this realm that is not organic. But monk fruit, I'm really excited about. Stevia has been around for a long time. I prefer the liquid brand of stevia. I hope you found this information about sugar interesting and helpful, and you'll start applying some of the things that you learned here. This is Davis, the founder of VitaLife, reminding you that today is the day to live a vital life.